In this section, we're going to be using the graphics design editor to start creating our user interfaces for our WinCC demo project. We're going to create the main screen, which is going to have navigation buttons, which will change the screen that is displayed in the picture window. We'll have an alarm banner to show us active alarms. We'll have a label to show us the name of the screen we're on, as well as the logged on user. We'll have a login button to allow users to log in. And we'll also have an ActiveX clock so we can see what time and date it is. So let's get started. We're going to begin in the WinCC Explorer. I'll highlight Graphics Designer and click to open. The Graphics Designer will open. And we're going to create a new screen. So I'll just do File, New, and it will open a new screen. Screens in WinCC are called PDLs, which stands for Picture Description Language. So we use the term PDL and screen interchangeably. The first thing I want to do is save this to the proper name and resolution. So I'll do File, Save As, and we're going to call this main.pdl. Next, I'm going to set the screen resolution. My properties dialog is docked below, so I can just pull it up to have more access to it. I'll go to geometry, and I'll set my picture width to 1024, and my height to 768. And of course, this is going to depend on what target hardware you're going to run these screens on. It may be a smaller panel, or it may be a large screen. Next, under effects, I'm going to turn off the global color scheme. This is going to allow me to change the colors and shading of the screen if I want to. We'll also do this with some of the objects that we place on the screen. And then I'm just going to save. Next, I want to put my navigation buttons at the top. On the right-hand side, I'm on the standard template. So under Windows, I'm going to highlight button, and I'm going to place a button out. And it's going to give me the button configuration dialog. And so my first button, I'm going to label overview. So when I press this button, it's going to show my overview screen that we're going to create later. And I will click OK. Now, if I want to change the font size or the color, another way that I can do this is through the property dialog with the button selected. You can tell that it's selected because of the black handles around the object. So under font, I'll set my font size to something appropriate, say 24. Now I'm going to need 6 buttons, so I'm just going to go ahead and duplicate this button and size them appropriately. So there's 3, and then notice that I can lasso and it selects all 3, and then I can duplicate and I can get 3 more. So if I want to evenly space all of these buttons, then I can use my arrow keys to finally place it. I place the first one and the last one. And then I use my lasso to surround all the buttons. And I'm going to use evenly spaced horizontally. So now I've got a row of buttons. I just need to go change the fonts. So this next button, I'll change the text to detail. I can also use the configuration dialog to use the same dialog we did before. It's really just a preference thing. This will be my admin screen button. On the next button, I'll change the text to alarms. This will be the screen that shows our alarm overview screen. And then we will have a trend screen. And then finally, we're going to have a button that allows us to stop runtime. So I'm going to set the label on this to stop RT, and I'll use the color palette to turn it red. But before I do that, I have to go to effects and turn off the global color scheme. So the global color scheme allows us to change the way all objects of a certain type look in one place, but it doesn't allow you to change individual objects if this property is on. So notice if I have this button highlighted and I select different colors on the palette, nothing happens. But if I turn this off, then I have access to the properties. So I'm just going to leave this red. Now that I have my navigation buttons in place, I'm going to put a picture window. A picture window is basically like a browser, but it shows WinCC screens instead of web pages. And this is how we can switch which screens the operators are interfacing with. We use a picture window object. So I will click the object. I'm not holding down any mouse buttons. And then I'll find the upper left corner of where I want to put it. I will hold down my left mouse key and I will drag out the picture window to an appropriate size. And of course, we can tweak this a little bit later. And again, I'm going to highlight this picture window object and just use my arrow keys to finally place it where I want. Next, I'm going to place the alarm banner. The alarm banner is just going to be a simple banner that shows us active alarms. And then we'll have an alarm overview page that shows us all the details. In order to get the alarm banner, I'm going to need to go to the controls palette down here in the lower right-hand corner. I'll highlight that. I will find my WinCC alarm control, and I'm just going to drag it out. Now, when I drag it out, it is going to show me the properties. And there's, of course, a lot of stuff on here, but we're going to whittle this down so that it's really only showing date, time, and the alarm message. So on the General tab, I am going to turn off Movable, Closable, and Sizable, and I'm going to turn off the title. Next, I'll also turn off the scroll bars. Again, we want this to be as simple as necessary. On the Parameters screen, I am going to turn off my Row Label and my Column Header. On the Toolbar, I'm going to turn off my toolbar, and I'll do the same thing on my status bar. I'm going to hit apply so you can see the changes that we're making. So we've kind of got it whittled down to where we can show a couple of alarms. And then finally, I will go to my message lists, and these are the blocks that are going to be shown. We want to show date, time, and message text. We don't necessarily need alarm number, so I'm just going to highlight alarm number, send it back over. And then on the message text, I'll add it active and hit apply. And you can see that's going to show my alarm text. Then I'll click OK. So now that we see how big our alarms are going to be, I'll probably make this a little smaller. And it's really preference, how many alarms do you want to show? So let's say 3. And then I'll make my picture window a little bit bigger. Next, we'll put in some labels to show us what screen that the user is currently viewing, as well as give them controls to log on and see the date and time. I'll go back to my standard palette, and I am going to use a static text object, which is really just a label, and I'm going to place it next to my alarm banner, pull it out at an appropriate size. I'll just kind of eyeball it right now. And then I'm just going to put some placeholder text in there called page name. And I'll use my properties dialog. I'm going to scroll down so you can see it. I'll use my properties dialog to set my font size a little higher and also change my text orientation to centered. Next, we're going to add another static text that's going to show the username, and it's going to be a little smaller. So I'll pull that out and just put in placeholder text of username. And I'll set my alignment centered as well. And my font size may be a little smaller. I'll use my cursor control keys to finally place. Next, I'll need a login button. So I am going to just take a standard Windows button. And for the text, I'll just put login. And later we'll add a function call to call the login dialog. And finally, I need to add a clock. So under controls, I will find the WinCC digital analog clock control. And it looks like I'm going to have to do some resizing, but I'll go ahead and just size this here. And notice it comes out and it looks like an analog clock instead of digital. So let's get our sizing done first, and then we'll make that look like a digital clock. First, I'm going to take my picture window, give myself a little room, and I'm going to highlight my button and my user text and just kind of use my arrows to pull that up. And then I'll size my clock And then I'll also size my other controls. So this is going to be my picture name. And then we can size these to kind of match. And then I'll pull this back down. So next, we're going to make this look like a digital clock. So I'm going to double click. And since it's an ActiveX, it's going to give me the ActiveX properties. I'm going to uncheck analog display and hit apply. And then I'm going to set my background style as transparent. And then on my font size, we're going to give it something that we can see. I can also use the WinCC properties dialog. So if the clock is selected, I can go to control properties, and I have to turn off my global color scheme in order to be able to change those properties. So make sure you do that. And then it shows in a nice black font by default. There's not an alignment property, so I'm just going to change the size and shape of this, since it's transparent, to make it appear aligned. And then I'll pull this down, and that's what our main screen looks like. Now that we have our page laid out, there's a couple of things we need to do. Most importantly, we need to save this page. So I'll just hit save. And then we want to set this as our default screen. This is going to be the screen that automatically shows when we go to runtime, and then they will show child screens in this picture window by pressing the buttons. So we're going to go back to WinCC Explorer and highlight Graphics Designer. You'll see that we have main PDL in our list now. I will right click that and do define picture as start picture. This will tell WinCC that this is our default screen when we go to runtime. Next up, we'll create child screens for each of the buttons.